Yo, but ask, write the government and ask them, where did they get all that gold from Fort Knox, man? Okay? Well, how does, you know, about $50 million worth of gold coins just all of a sudden appear in somebody's backyard over 500 years ago? It was dug up. That's the gold that they stole, and they couldn't carry it all. The white man rather hide the gold, or rather just take the food and destroy it, rather than do good and rather give it to some homeless shelter or some hungry person. I'm telling you, that's their nature. They're a bunch of greedy damn people. I'm going to continue. Love the Lord all thy life and call upon him for thy salvation. I do that every night. I want to get the hell up out of here, boy. Bad. I'm telling you. I need some slaves bad. Okay? 15th verse. It says, now listen up to this one real carefully. It says, every beast loveth his life. And every man. Now this is very interesting right here. This is what the Most High is saying. He made all the beasts, okay, like you got a lion, like you got a rabbit, like you got a horse, like you got a cow. The Most High said, every beast loveth his like. Meaning every beast, you're not going to see a horse, okay, mating with a lion. Simple. It says, every beast loveth his like. It says, and every man loveth his neighbor. Uh-oh. Let's look up the word neighbor. What does the word neighbor mean? Because you so-called Negroes that go to church, you love thy neighbor. Look, there we go right there. Love thy neighbor. That means if you got a Chinese over here, that's my neighbor. You got a white, that's my neighbor. We supposed to love everybody. The Bible says, love thy neighbor. You just read it. Let's look up in the Bible dictionary. Okay, what does the word neighbor mean? Okay, when it comes to the Most High. Now, okay, it says neighbor. It says, Commandments 6 through 10 deal with duties towards one's neighbor. It says, Old Testament neighbor meant one who lived nearby. Now, in the past, the Most High separated the nations. We didn't have, when we lived in our own land, we didn't have a Chinese living next door to us. We didn't have an African, a Cushite living over there. We didn't have an Edomite living next door to us over there. We didn't have a Moabite living over there. Okay, it says, a neighbor meant one who lived nearby, a fellow Israelite. Meaning, get a close-up on that if they think I'm lying. It says, a neighbor meant a fellow Israelite. So when it says, love thy neighbor, that means that you're supposed to love your brother and your sister, not everybody. The Most High made it plain, it usually meant a fellow Israelite. Okay, so if you're of a descent of a race, okay, it's nothing wrong with loving your own race. Okay, you're supposed to love your neighbor, meaning your brother and your sister. Okay, that what? That's of your nation. So let me finish this up in Ecclesiastes 13 and 15. It says, every beast loveth his life. Okay, you can't get a rabbit to mate with a chicken. Okay, totally impossible. Okay, the so-called white man is a Frankenstein monster. That's the reason why he always try to crossbreed every damn thing. He's out of his mind. He's insane. The Most High said, every beast loveth his life. That's the way the Most High made it. Okay, for two rabbits to mate, for two sharks to mate, not a shark and a billy goat to mate. The white man is a damn jackass, man. And the Heavenly Father tells you that. It says, and every man loveth his neighbor. I'm going to continue. It says, all flesh consorteth according to kind. Meaning your flesh, you consort with your own kind, okay? That's why do you think it's so difficult when you go to work or when you're in school, it's so difficult to strike up a conversation with another nation of people because you're not the same people, okay? The Most High is going to explain that to you. We got diverse ways from each other. Why do you think when you're alone in a room with a damn cracker, why do you think he talks about one thing and you talk about another? He eats a certain food and you eat another certain food. Listen up. All flesh consorteth according to kind. Okay? You got blacks over here, that's our kind. You got Africans over there, that's their kind. This is what the Most High is saying. He says, all flesh consorteth to kind, and man will cleave to his like. Okay? It says, what fellowship hath the wolf with the lamb? Now the Most High is making a comparison. He said, what fellowship do a wolf got with a lamb? Meaning, what business do a lamb and a wolf got hanging out with one another? It says, so the sinner with the godly. Okay, so the Most High is saying, what business do a sinner got to do with a godly person? If you ever notice or not, when you're trying to bring yourself back to the law, statutes, commandments, and you're trying to do right, okay, and you have a sinner, they're always trying to pull you right back into that realm, okay, of sin. The more steps you take forward, if you hang around a sinner, they're going to try to push you right on back because Satan don't like righteousness, okay? It says, what agreement, 18th verse, what agreement is there between a hyena and a dog? He's making another comparison. What the hell agreement is there with a hyena and a dog, okay? They ain't got no agreement together because they don't hang out together, okay? It says, and what peace between the rich and the poor? He's specifying those are totally two different categories because, why? Because when you sit amongst a poor person, when they sit amongst a rich person, we don't really have nothing in common, okay? Your bank account says $50 million. Mine may say $50. So what are we going to talk about, okay? Unless you're going to talk about putting some of your money inside of my bank account, or we can talk all night then, okay? But other than that, the Most High is saying, what conversation do a rich person got to do with a poor person, okay? And he's saying every man going to consort with his own life. Why do you think, let me ask you so-called Negroes something. Okay, I'm going to read something real heavy. Watch this. Okay, why do you think, okay, that when you look, okay, why do you think that when, and oftentimes, why do you think that that you and the so-called white man has never got along, or you guys don't eat the same foods, or why do you think you don't eat the same foods, or anything like that? Because the Heavenly Father, what did he do? The Heavenly Father made us different, okay, from one another. Now, I'm going to read that in the book of Ecclesiastes, the 33rd chapter. Now, listen to this one real good. This is going to knock your socks off. Ecclesiastes 33. It is in the Apocrypha. Ecclesiastes 33, and this is the 10th verse. Now, listen up to this one real good. If you think I'm lying, listen to the scriptures. It says, and all men are from the ground, because that's what we're made from. Made from the dust of the earth, okay? The Heavenly Father made us out of water and put blood in us to give us life. It says, and all men are made from the ground, the dust of the earth. It says, Adam was created of the earth. 11th verse. And much knowledge the Most High have divided them. Okay? It says, and made their ways diverse. Our ways are diverse. We don't eat the same foods as Chinese people. Okay? Why do you think the Heavenly Father is explaining it to you right now? Why do you think our minds are different from the way the Europeans think? The Europeans' minds are different from the way the Africans think. The Africans' minds are different from the way a Hawaiian think, okay? The Most High said this. He said, in much knowledge, the Lord have divided them, okay? You Negroes want to integrate with everybody. And made their ways diverse. He gonna make it plain to you. 12th verse. Some of them have he blessed. Now, we know who the blessed people is, okay? That's Israel, okay? Christ said that. He says, some of them have he blessed and exalted, some of them have he sanctified and set near himself, but some of them have he cursed and brought low. And when the so-called white man was in them caves, he was brought to a low estate. He refused to accept that history, okay, and that beginning where he came from, which are the Caucasus Mountains of South Georgia, Russia, okay?